Okay, so today I need to, I hate to say this again, I need to look at the importation and export, the IMEX, the import-export again. Because right now this is mostly hard-coded in, if I recall correctly, yes. Which isn't going to scale very well in a larger system. Program project, or it is not dynamic for adding new stuff either. And it makes it very succinct, but it's not very good in the long term. So, I need to make this system non-hard coded. Now, let's have a look what we got. Brings in this, determines what type it is, and then kind of adds them. Okay. What if, okay, this is going to require render state, no, resource pools. Okay, I'm going to start with resources as always. Or actually, yeah. Nope. Yes. No, not this simulation set. There we go. What I'm thinking of is rather than having these all static, is I'm going to have to do like a set of like a vector of vector of something along the lines of this. And then I'd also write, because right now, go to here. Resource loaders. I'd also need something similar for the resource loaders. Before declared. It's this entire thing, 4 kilobytes almost. Hi. Right. Resource loaders are pretty expensive size-wise. And so is group data. Actually, group data makes a lot of sense because it's an array. Okay, let's focus on resource pools first. What I'm going to do under here is we're going to create a new like pool base. That's going to be, well, a base that we're going to inherit from. So we have this, we include. No, actually, we don't even need that. We just struct. And this will be inheritable, so it'll be like virtual destructor, which will be defaulted. Do I need to export? No, because it's declared and defined right here. Yeah. It's under the pools. Include that here. Okay, we'll just do the one for the moment. So when we create a simulation set, what we can do is as part, like a default constructor. So then that's a pointer of wherever this is automatically added to this pool list. I'm building everything, right? And debug, and yeah, okay. So at that point, what we're going to have to do on the function registrar, I'm thinking like, do I want to? No. A thought is that I could actually add like the loader to, let's say, the armature create info. Like I have a pointer here to the object, or the object and function. But if like this object is copied into another simulation set, that's going to invalidate that. So I can't do that. Can I? No. And this isn't even building anyways. Undefined reference to VTable. Armature pool. Do I need to like export the entire class? Well, I don't want to do that because that's also going to export these two, which are like, I don't need these symbols to be exported. In fact, that's kind of dangerous on Microsoft's on Windows with DLLs and that. Reference to VTable. Type info. Clang. Okay. Must have needed this earlier sometime. It's not even here. Okay, cute. The solution is to ensure that all virtual methods that are not pure are defined. Well, that is certainly the case. There's no virtual in there. So, yeah, there's no, yeah. Okay, what if I do this? It's because it's empty anyways. No, that's not going to work. Evidently. Okay, what about disability? Oh, that's just regular visibility. MSVC compatibility mode. This is an old thing, but it could work. This. If we add this, okay. To this library. So we can say if not MSVC. Compile options for resource private. We add that. Okay. That works. For now, I'll take it. Okay. The other thing we want to do then is, we have the pool base. We also want the loader base. Then we include this here. sure we don't have to export this either. Okay, looking good there. Okay. So those two that way. Come back to simulation set, we'll add that. Now for the interesting part, I'm going to add a namespace here where we're going to have let's say we have another function that'll go alongside like the import function. Maybe like the create. Because, okay, what am I doing here? I am taking the info that I've imported and I'm going to create an armature or create a mesh or create something like that. Because when I'm loading it from that type, I already know what type it is. But at this point, I have no idea what type it is. So I need the ability, okay. We'll do something like this. It has a function that takes in the, when I'm creating, I need the resource ID. I need the create info that I got. Then I need the faux resource pool loader base. And then that. Don't actually need to know what these are. But what I can do is, and at this point I can go for an iterator of resource pools. I can do a dynamic cast because this is a very rare operation. I mean, is it? It is a pretty rare operation. I'm only doing it during loading. The initial loading, which I'm willing to sacrifice a little bit of time on, I think. And then I can refine it later. What I need is for it to work right now. Cool star. Iterator. don't have it. Just continue. Otherwise, p armature pool. And I mean, this is just this part, right? I could just do it right here. This returns a bool, just in case it doesn't for whatever reason. Taken, what is it? This is the resource ID. And the loader. We need to find the loader. Okay, we do that. Something like this. They start off as null pointer. Break out, do the same thing for loader. Don't do that. Instead, it's that. Okay. If either of those are missing, we can't do it. Otherwise, we're here, so auto star P armature. Going to take the resource and the P armature loader for the moment. I've got to really refocus on how to do loading. I don't want to have loaders be directly part of resources anymore. Maybe like I can maybe point to the resource loader like list. Maybe. I'm just not okay. I'm just not entirely sure. Not sure. At any rate, we try to if we fail to add it, I need to delete parameter. We need to return a false, we need to return a true. Okay. If we're going to do this, so we need a second function to be added to the importer base. If we're importing resource definitions, that means we need to have basically these two. Here. What is the order of this? This is like first, then value set, then index generator. Then state pools. Then resource pools and loaders. Then that. Okay. Let's make these references, shall we? So then required. Resource loaders 2. Resource pools. There. Okay. Distributed YAML here. Nope. Doing that. We also got here the dummy thing. Okay, I don't quite have it yet. What I'm thinking of is that when we're here, we're going to add importer. So we have the import function. The creation function will be bool function pointer takes in these. Okay, then we, and when we're adding importer, these need to be changed. So P, it's not the import functions, it's P resource functions. Rather than that, it's a back down to the source side, we will be, so the key is still the same, that's great. Get out of the way. Param p import. So it's not, it's sorry, not that, it's create function. Okay, that leads me back to here where I need to add it for here. And then the rest of these have to be null pointer for the moment. Okay. Back, jumping back to distributed YAML here. So we have this. Resource functions. Okay. Import. If that's the case, so that this should only be for the armature node. I'm gonna do it.second.pcreate node. The create info I have. Pass those through. So it's not node, it'd be resource. Okay, where is this from then? Group data doesn't even do anything. I just added it here. Whoops, whoops. Okay, we're here. Fails, we need to return false out of here. This is getting pretty deep. And no matter the case, we need to delete the create info. Okay, that should realistically mean I no longer have to have the P armature section. Because there will only be one. think we're on this one, which is collision shape. Sorry. Oh, collision shape is number one right now. Whoops. I thought it would be. Wait, it's both first and last. Okay. Cool. Don't know what happened there. Must have been some old debug code or some test that I just left in. Whoopsie. So now, this is for armature, right? Armature V1, right? Okay. Going inside. It's great. We have one resource pool. It's the armature one. Got that one, that one. We did this. We created it. We added it successfully. We then we're out. Oh, we also need to set it to be. We could just leave it actually right now. Okay. One. 43 minutes and got one of them done. Is there anything else I can really think of at the moment to do with this? Not really. I mean, if I do this, actually, because I no longer require. I'm still using our resource pools and stuff. It's just for this, right? And down here, yeah. So be able to clean this up, which will be good. Yeah. Okay. Time to buckle down and get the rest of these done. So let's just close everything. We'll just speed through the loaders and the pools. Put that on the right. This one on the right. Okay. Loader base. Go with the pool. Okay, we got all those. Simulation set. Now we've got to add them all here. Declaration of this. Collision shape is going to have to be done in a second. Now I think about it. That's the one I didn't want to have. This is it right here. Make sure all that's going to compile fine. Not quite. In instantiation of this. Here, resources.collisionShape. Instantiation of function template, okay. And place back of that, requested here. Candidate template ignored substitution failure with resource pool base. Cannot initialize a new value of type foe resource pool base star with a. Oh, yes. Yeah, this is on the wrong thing right here. My bad. Okay. MS compatibility. I need that here as well, I guess. Okay, nice. Make sure it runs, and then I'll start adding the create functions. Okay. Other than that one bug right now, it runs, yes. Wonderful. Okay, so let's add the create functions for the others, which we will, for the moment, put in the function register. Eventually, what I'm going to do is I'm going to move these back up into like the resource library, so I'll actually be able to get rid of a fair amount of things here, if I think about it. Yeah. Anyways, so that's armature. I will do what mesh next. We do this, we remove it from here. Maybe not. Oh, I need the actual. Okay, material. Vertex descriptor. Shader. Okay. What happened? Oh. I hate this. Can I turn this off? Maybe some other time. Okay, then now we need to add the includes material. Ah, whatever. Nope, 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 not quite. Let's get that material. Just use collision shape from elsewhere. This still has fizz prefix to these, which really shouldn't anymore. Okay, now this is going to cause a memory leak because of the lack of that, for sure, unless, okay, whatever. For the moment, let's just see if this thing even works, shall we? All of these, do they work? Seemingly they do. If I didn't even have this, then nothing would work at all, right? Yeah. that's the other bug instead for now. That means we no longer require these two here. Nor here. Nor here. It also means we're no longer tied to having to be in source, because those were the things that were tying it to here. Oh no, I still got state pools. Still got one more to do. Right, because I've just done the resource side. I need to do the same thing for the component data side. That means there's here as well. And wherever it's just called, which we'll find out in a second. So these two, gone. Or, yeah. Do I still even need these? Oh no, I got the whole simulation set right. Okay, do I want to move this now or just, okay, you know what, I'll actually probably just stage what I have as a first kind of area. Okay, we'll do two parts. First of all, the resource section. Base struts. In order to export,
the entirety of the
need to change that. No, I don't really want to do this. Not here. Realistically, what? I'm still tied down by the state pools, right? The state pools are all still down here. That's the one type I'm still here with. Import state data. Okay, before I do this, what's the only state data I don't have available here is, like, as part of source, is position, if I recall, and physics. These are the only external ones. So, can I do the same kind of deal here? I think so. Because what's going on in here? Import state that. It's just passing that through again. So it really doesn't, okay, this doesn't actually need to know what it is yet, because it's just passing it through. Oh, but it needs to know what this one, this is instead. Okay. Okay, no, we will put this resource, at least got the resource side done. Kind of there, closer. No. Okay. I really Okay, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start moving the function registrar up into other locations, such as this. So, resource, or would it be here? No, it'd be under this. This is where it would go. Like, the function registrar would be for the YAML, and processing would be linked into the core resource library. I mean, that's where the create functions would be coming from, these ones. To my mind, yes. I just need to make sure that now these are all predefined already. So let's do this. This is currently sitting up here. Okay, this is actually going to be quite a bit more. So I'm going to leave this here as it is. And I'll make this another day because I got to think about this a little bit more. All right, cheers.